We can play or we can pose. That's the angry ultimatum Bob Dylan gave to his audience when he got upset over all the cell phones taking photos at his concert. Should they be banned? We'll dig into that very question coming up next on Track by Track. Hey everybody, my name's Kyle and this is Track by Track, music reviews, news, and commentary. Thanks for tuning in today, and if this is your first time here, please take a second to click subscribe so that you won't miss future reviews and more. The times, they are a-changing, but Bob Dylan doesn't want to accept that. Ever since the smartphone put a high-definition camera in everyone's pocket, live concerts have been documented on photo and video and shared across social media almost in real time. And while many shows have a no-cameras policy, it's an ideal that's nearly impossible to police. That's what Bob Dylan found out recently. He's long had a so-called ban on cameras at his shows, but fans are still likely to be holding up their phones during the performance, particularly during some of his most iconic songs. Now that's exactly what happened on April 16th in Vienna. Dylan was just one verse into Blowin' in the Wind when he stopped to chastise the audience for taking pictures. Ironically, the entire incident was captured via cell phone photos and video, which were shared on social media. So here's how the scene played out. Dylan and his band were barely into the song Blowin' in the Wind when the singer became agitated and mumbled something about pictures into the microphone. Taking a step back, he stumbled over one of the stage monitors and nearly fell to the floor. Gathering himself up, he returned to the mic and made an announcement.
I say once again, take pictures. Oh, don't take pictures. We're gonna either play or we're gonna pose.
After that, he paused as if he was indeed striking a pose. From there, he moved to the piano and switched songs to It Takes a Lot to Laugh, It Takes a Train to Cry. And when that song was over, Dylan unceremoniously exited the stage, leaving the band to play the final song of the night, just like Tom Thumb's Blues, as an instrumental. All right, let's unpack this a bit. First of all, if you've ever seen Bob Dylan in concert, you know he's a man of few words. In fact, over the past couple years, he's been a man of no words. He comes out, he sings his songs, and he leaves the stage without ever saying a word to the audience, not even introducing the band. So the fact that he even spoke at all during the Vienna show was a minor event. Now I totally understand how it may be frustrating to performers to be on stage and look out across the audience to see an ocean of cell phones. There's a certain irony to the fact that at a live event, so many people are experiencing the show through a tiny screen. In fact, I'm willing to bet that everyone watching this video has taken a photo with their phone during a concert. Everybody does it. Does that make it right? I'm not sure, but I don't believe it makes it wrong. As I said before, the times have changed. For better or worse, cell phones are now part of the concert-going experience. They're not going away, and I don't think there's any realistic way to ban them or prevent people from using them. The most high-profile attempt to curb cell phone use at shows is probably Jack White. He's instituted a program where the audience has to have their phones locked into pouches before they can enter the theater. They can keep their phones with them at all times, but they can only unlock the pouches and remove the phones when they are outside the auditorium. Now, while I think Jack White's solution is a novel idea, I don't think it's scalable, shall we say. I think the logistics of requiring this at larger shows would be ridiculously cumbersome. On top of that, the whole program is just one tragic incident away from being discontinued. Imagine an emergency situation at or during a concert when the inability to have immediate access to a cell phone might be the difference between life and death. So what about cell phone etiquette at concerts? Obviously, there's no formal rules about this other than when an act or a venue brazenly tries to decree no cell phones for their event. I think everyone has their own idea about what is acceptable behavior. My personal approach has been to only take a handful of pictures during a concert and to be as quick and discreet about it as possible so as not to potentially disturb the audience around me. Still, I often see people who seem to have their phones out and recording video for nearly every song. Do I find that annoying? Kind of, I guess, but as long as your phone isn't obstructing anyone's view, I'm mostly inclined to shrug it off. But honestly, when it comes to concert etiquette, there's all kinds of audience behaviors that tend to be more disruptive, in my opinion, than taking pictures or photos on cell phones. If we're going to talk about banning things at concerts, how about banning talking, drinking, standing, dancing, eating, leaving to go to the bathroom in the middle of the show? Am I serious? Of course not. But chances are, if you've ever been to a concert, you've gotten annoyed by audience behavior related to at least one of those things. So what's the answer? Stay home? If you don't like that scene, then don't buy a ticket? That's fair, I guess, but if that's your attitude, you better take everything that goes with it, including people taking photos and videos on their phones. And when it comes to the performers, while I understand their frustrations, it doesn't change the fact that every night when they're on stage, there's hundreds, if not thousands of people in their audience that paid a lot of money to be able to take a few crappy pictures to share on Facebook or Instagram. Meanwhile, some acts are actually embracing smartphone use at their shows. U2 has developed augmented reality visualizations for their audiences that can only be experienced by using their smartphone cameras during their concerts. They're trying to find ways to transform the devices that sometimes seem to separate the audience from the performer into gateways to a more immersive live experience. Considering the fact that U2 has famously incorporated cutting-edge technology and multimedia into their shows for over 20 years, it's no surprise to see them adopting augmented reality and other smartphone capabilities. The Bob Dylan live show, on the other hand, is nearly the antithesis of that. And that's fine, he doesn't need videos and lasers and fancy light rigs and all that, but his notoriously aloof stage persona has done nothing to dissuade audiences from taking pictures. In Vienna, he said, "We can either play or we can pose." I would argue he actually does both at every show. He presents his music like a portrait hanging in a gallery. He presents his art without comment or context. And perhaps no other musician alive today has earned the status, acclaim, and reverence to command or justify such piety of their patrons. But that doesn't change the fact that we're talking about the very nature of live performance. The point of being there is to experience the connection between audience and performer. And the way people enjoy that experience has evolved. Yes, I've seen people taking pictures on cell phones at every concert I've been to in the past 10 years, but I've also seen plenty of performers taking selfies from the stage to share in their social media feeds. It's part of how they stay connected with their fans. And how does Bob Dylan stay connected with his fans? The answer is, he doesn't. The man gives no indication that he cares at all about his audience. Granted, he's been that way for decades, and if you're a Dylan fan, you kind of have to accept that. His performances are workmanlike at best. And if that's the kind of show that he wants to put on, and the fans don't mind paying for it, I think that's fine. But the concert experience has changed since his early days, and it's unrealistic for Dylan to expect audiences in 2019 to behave like they did half a century ago in the 1960s. Actually, the whole thing calls to mind one of Bob Dylan's most infamous performances on May 17, 1966. That was the night in Manchester, England, when an angry fan yelled "Judas" at Dylan in protest to the singer going electric. Ultimately, I think it is fair to say audiences came around to Bob Dylan's evolving sound, and the notion of him playing electric guitar became not just forgiven, but accepted. Fast forward 53 years to Vienna, where, to me, Dylan breaking years of silence to rant about his fans taking pictures feels a bit like yelling "Judas" from the stage. He's upset because the audience is plugged in. They're connected 24/7. They're in the cloud. And as much as they may love and appreciate Zimmerman's old-school legacy, they're not going to ditch electric any more than he did with Blonde on Blonde. Should audiences have better etiquette at concerts? For cell phone use and so much more, I think the answer is a resounding yes. But banning pictures at concerts is not the answer, any more than banning beer, banning dancing, banning singing along, or banning yelling "Freebird." Okay, maybe that last one should be banned. But seriously, as much as I love and respect the legendary Bob Dylan, I think he's more than a little out of touch here. He is one of the great gods of rock and roll. Is it too much to grant his acolytes the opportunity to digitally immortalize him in the new church of social media? But maybe I'm off base here. Maybe acts like Bob Dylan and Jack White are onto something by taking a strict no photos approach to their shows. What do you think? How would you feel about going to a show where cell phones are banned? Do you think that the price of your ticket should entitle you to be able to take a few photos or videos? Does the sea of smartphones held aloft at concerts truly annoy you? Let me know what you think down in the comments section below. Once again, my name is Kyle, and this has been Track by Track. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Plus, check out some of these other videos below that I think you might also enjoy. And of course, be sure to subscribe, because true music fans always want new releases the day they come out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.